school, I had all these ideas of what you would do when you're an adult is set goals and you achieve them and you keep moving forward, which is true. A lot of times you do set goals and that helps you to do the things that you want to do in life, but there are some times in life when goals isn't maybe the thing that helps you to focus on. So, for example, when I have a broken arm, I can't do much. I can't play violin. I can't do a lot of the stuff to take care of myself. I need a lot of help. And in those times when I can't always be focusing on my goals of like traveling or playing music or, you know, it helps me to remember that life is about more than just making progress. Life is about living in a way that enriches you and enriches other people. So even if I can't move around or do the things that I normally do, I can do things like appreciate music, right? Like listen to music. Or I can sit outside and just enjoy the sunshine, right? And everybody has the capacity to enjoy the world in some way. And so as you go out and you're getting older and you're planning your futures, don't forget that every day you're alive, regardless of whether or not you're where you want to be in 10 years or something, you can be appreciating the world in the present moment. And you also have a lot of power to help other people appreciate the world. People who do care work, like nurses, have you ever noticed that even if somebody is like about to pass away, they're very compassionate in an ideal world. They're very compassionate and loving because we can sense love and compassion until the very last second we're alive. My grandfather passed away at age 94 and he was in hospice, and I remember playing for him and he hadn't spoken in 3 days. So he really wasn't super cognizant anymore. And so I was playing for him and all of a sudden he started making some noise, and the nurse came in and she thought maybe he was in pain. And as we listened, he was singing along to Amazing Grace with me 3 days after he had stopped talking, because I think things like music and things like love really reach you even until the very last second of your life. So for you, I hope that you do reach your goals, but I also hope that you take time to do things that enrich you. And it's gonna be different for everybody. Some of you get a lot of joy out of music, some is nature, some is just being with a close friend, or reading a book, but take time to do that stuff so that you can be happy in life, whether or not you are exactly where you want to be in 10 years, because that is important to enjoy the present moment. So I'm gonna play for you some songs, and I'm super pumped about the fact that the orchestra is gonna join me on a song that I wrote called Birdsong. And this song is about how even if our bodies are limited, our spirits are not. So I'm really excited to bring them out. And thank you for having me today. It's gonna be very fun.
This is one of Dion's bandmates. This is Dave Bailey. Denfeld High School 2004! He has his own band called the Fontanelles. They were in the paper this morning, a picture of Gaelynn playing with them. But I've seen them play together. He's in his band. They hooked up in the Twin Cities. It's really cool to get Duluth together, east and west.
Yes, we can coexist. Yes, Dave. Yeah.
Thank you.
Driving through, driving through. and I'm gonna bring my friend Dave out, and my dad as well, who is a good harmonica player. He's gonna join us. I know, you're learning so much about tonight.
Wade's gonna play the harmonica. Teacher gonna play the harmonica.
Had you?
Mr. Wade.
Oh.
Music and other kind of creative things, I think, are what keeps us enjoying life, so keep doing it in some way or form. Doesn't have to be in a band, you can do whatever makes you happy. But I hope you get to continue to explore new things, and good luck with graduation to all you seniors. And this tune is called Metsukukiya. I use a looping pedal in my wheelchair here, it records what I'm playing and then plays it back again and again, so you'll hear it. This is kind of an experimental take on a very old traditional fiddle tune. So here we go.
Thank you. Okay, we'd like to thank Dave and Gaelynn and Mr. White for the assembly today. Denfeld's Key Club collected money, Gaelynn, through our coin wars. And with the help of all these students, we are donating a total of $208.29 to National Endowment. That's a, so good job, Denfeld. And Gold Lunch, you will be getting a prize on Monday. You'll have an open campus, so it's supposed to be 70 degrees that day. I'm not sure. Good job, Gold Lunch. So thank you, Denfeld, and you can go to your